All right, today we're at Midwest Gym Supply, and what we're going to do is show how to remove the inside reflex mechanism, the whole bottom plate basically, of a balance beam. And this is especially done if you're planning on redoing the top either by yourself or if you do one of our replacement beam tops. This is a procedure that's needed to replace that top or to replace the suede and pad on your own top. So the first thing we'll do is we can take a look at some of the tools that we're going to need to be ready so that this will enable you to do this procedure. To start off with, we're going to loosen up the bolts that are in the bottom of the beam that squeeze. They have plates on the inside of the beam that these bolts attach to that squeezes the bottom plate to the inside plate, and that will be taken out by this. This is a Allen wrench socket, a regular Allen wrench, which is a 7/32 size. This is a socket of a 7/32 Allen wrench that sometimes will let you do it in a faster and more efficiently. So now I'll loosen up these bolts, and these front bolts here, these two front bolts, you can loosen up all the way until you hear or you feel the bolt come loose, and you can pull the bolt all the way out. So I'll just keep spinning and loosening the bolt until I feel the bolt then come all the way loose. And we'll set that down. I'll do this back one. Sometimes it's tough to get a socket into this position, so I'll show you also how to use the regular Allen wrench. This is a 7/32 again. This bolt in the back is the one that I do not recommend that you undo or loosen until it comes completely loose, because what is attached to the plate on the inside, as you will see when we pull this out, is the springs that act as a counterbalance to the weight of the beam so that it's easier to move the beam to different heights. So we'll just loosen this up a little bit, and I'll show you then further about how far we'll loosen that a little bit later, but now I'll go take out the front bolt. And I can hear the plate on the inside drop out, so now this bolt is all completely free. Now what I'm going to do is I will loosen up this T-handle. What this does is that it drops down the spring mechanism that is on rollers that travels to different positions as you change the level of the beam. And I'll loosen this up several turns. Okay, now I'm going to get a 3/4 inch wrench. And what we're going to do is we're going to loosen up this bolt here that also attaches this plate, this movable plate, for changing the height of the beam. I have a ratchet with a 3/4 inch socket on it, or you can use a regular wrench that is a 3/4 inch size. Again, loosening up this bolt will drop down the rollers and the spring mechanism the reflex mechanism that's on the inside of the beam and allow this plate then to be taken out from the center of the beam. Now, to make sure that I have the bolt in the very back loose enough, I will pull out this end cap. It's just spring loaded, and what we'll do is just turn it so that it fits right on the inside of the beam, which then it will come out as we pull the end plate off. And I'll continue to loosen this up. I can feel the end of the bolt in here, and I will loosen this up until it is close to maximum distance without coming all the way loose from the inside plate, because you don't want to do that. Alright, and this isn't. Alright, I'm going to have to use the regular Allen wrench to do this. A little bit farther. Okay, I think that's far enough. I don't want to go any farther and detach that plate. Now the next thing I will do to get this ready to be slid out the back end of this beam is that I want to make sure that this plate is not stuck to the suede that it's pressing down against. And after it's been tight for sometimes several years, then this suede can be stuck to this plate. And in order to break it loose, I use some type of a prying device. This is just a standard pry bar. This is like a painter's spatula, and I'll show you what I do with it. Okay. The end here is broken loose. I use this pry bar as to pry the end of it up, and then I can use this to make sure that the suede is not stuck to the bottom of the metal plate. And once I check to make sure that this is all loose, this looks good. Let me do this. There we go. I'm going to walk in front here. Maybe I can do it from here. There we go. So you can see the end of the plate has popped up, so I know that everything is free now on the bottom of the plate. Now what we'll do is I will grab a hold of this back leg here, and I will basically just pull the bottom, and it pulls out the whole mechanism from inside the beam. Make sure you use additional help because this is very heavy. Okay. And now we'll set that down. That's it. And from here then we can do the other end of the beam the same way. Again, it always helps that while we're working on this end of the beam, there should be somebody holding the other leg at the other end of the beam so that the leg doesn't fall over and put a twist in the beam. And that should allow you access then to the top so that you can either redo the top yourself or you can do an exchange with us and one of our reconditioned tops, or get a brand new top from AAI and then put that onto your beam, which makes it brand new. And that should do it as far as taking the leg and the bottom plate off.